Welcome. As you have seen in previous videos and exercises, the key to evaluating an integral is to find an antiderivative of the function that you want to integrate. Recall that an antiderivative of a function f is another function, say capital F, such that the derivative of capital F is equal to small f. We can also write this as follows. The integral of fx dx is equal to capital F of x plus c, where c is a constant. You've seen antiderivatives of many standard functions, but how can you find an antiderivative of combinations of these functions, like the ones on the slide? For differentiation, we have all kinds of rules that allow us to deal with combinations of functions. Are there such general rules for integration as well? Unfortunately, no. There is no set of general rules that allows us to evaluate all integrals. However, there are several integration techniques that may help you to simplify a given integral. One of these techniques is the so-called method of substitution that I will discuss in this video. To illustrate the method, let me start with an example. Suppose you want to find an antiderivative of the following function, cosine of x cubed plus 5x times 3x squared plus 5. Look at the structure. The first factor is the composition of two functions, a function f of x equal to cosine of x, and a function g of x equal to x cubed plus 5x. The second factor is precisely the derivative of g. Now we know an antiderivative of the cosine. It is the sine. Let's denote it by capital F. Then we see that the function that we try to integrate is of the following form. Capital F prime of gx times g prime of x. Do you recognize this expression? It is precisely the result of the chain rule for differentiation. It is equal to the derivative of capital F of g of x. So, capital F of g of x is a primitive function for the function that we are trying to integrate. Thus we find that the integral is equal to capital F of g of x plus c, that is, sine of x cubed plus 5x plus c. The whole story becomes slightly easier if we introduce a new variable u, defined as u equal to x cubed plus 5x. We can re-express the integral in terms of this variable. This is called substitution. How does it work? Well, first of all, cosine of x cubed plus 5x simply becomes cosine of u. Furthermore, we have the u dx equal to 3x squared plus 5. This we can rewrite to du equal to 3x squared plus 5 dx. So the second part of the integral can simply be replaced by du. The whole integral has now been rewritten as the integral of cosine u du. This is much easier to evaluate. It is equal to sine of u plus c. In the final step, we replace u by x cubed plus 5x, which gives the result sine of x cubed plus 5x plus c. What we used here is the so-called method of substitution. Let me summarize the steps. We start with a complicated integral. Then we choose a substitution, a new variable u related to the old variable x. Using the derivative of u, we find a relation between du, x, and dx. Armed with these relations, we can re-express the integral completely in terms of u and du. There should be no more x or dx. This new integral can be evaluated. And finally, we return to the original variable x, again by using the relation between u and x. And then we are done. Let me give you another example to illustrate the steps. Consider the integral of 1 divided by 1 plus x cubed times x squared dx. You can see that the first factor is a composition of fx equal to 1 over x and gx equal to 1 plus x cubed. When a composition occurs in an integral, it is often worthwhile to try to get rid of the inner function by using a substitution. So, in this case, we can try to make it simpler by using the substitution u equal 1 plus x cubed. It follows that du dx is equal to 3x squared. Therefore, du equals 3x squared dx. The factor x squared dx occurs in the integral, but the factor 3 does not occur. But we can rewrite the relation between du and dx as 1 over 3 du equal to x squared dx. Now we can re-express the entire integral in terms of u and du. Remember, there should be no more x or dx. We get the integral of 1 over u times 1 over 3 du. This is equal to 1 over 3 times the logarithm of the absolute value of u plus c. Then re-express this in terms of x. Now we have obtained the answer to our original integral, as you can easily check yourself. The question remains, given a complicated integral, how to find an appropriate substitution? That is a good question, and I cannot give you a recipe that will always work. The art of the method is to find a substitution that makes the original integral simpler. To get a feeling for this, you need to work out many examples. You can practice this in the exercises.